God said, "What I want to talk about is whatever you are open to today. Some days you are more open than other days. Of course, you are doing the best you can. The best you can means as far as you can see at this time. On the days and accumulations of woe, you may be open to listening the most of all, or, on such days, your mind may be firmly closed. You don't want to hear about anything woeful that you and your way of thinking may have contributed to. You may feel that you just can't be contrite anymore. Yet someday, perhaps in retrospect, your eyes will open, and you will see how you may well have contributed in some way. You are not to blame, yet you blame yourself. There is no blame, dear ones, unless you call being human as blame. There is responsibility, however. Playing your role here as human being alive on Earth, you are in a learning place. If you knew everything and made happiness-producing decisions at every turn, why would you be here? Now, at the same time as I say this, I am not saying that you are here only for lessons. Perhaps, we can sum up all lessons as one. You are here to learn joy even in the confines of the relative world. You're not here for punishment. You are being given a worldwide opportunity to learn how to learn joy on the job. This is your basic assignment, to learn joy, to discover it at every corner. To do this, you have to let go of the idea of your being perfect. And, yet, you are perfect, beloveds, perfectly you. You are also here to help others. I can say with certainty that you are here to help others and to help others grow. They can grow from your wisdom, and they can grow from your foolishness as well. Everyone is learning from you. They are learning their way around the world just as you are, and they see what you do and what you don't do, and they learn, and they grow from their observation of you. What a teacher you are! By design or by default, everyone learns from you. In joy or in sorrow, they learn from you. Set your shoulders back now, and seeming others will learn greatness of being from you. Greatness isn't sacrifice, beloveds. Not at all. Learn from those who fill themselves with love and naturalness. This is what you are learning and everyone is learning. This is the living truth. This is all you are learning, to give and return love as the most natural thing in the world. You are coming to this state where anything less than love is a stranger to you, this state where love feels right and nothing else does. With love, this is the way to live. Love is your nourishment, and love is your expression. This I call greatness. Of course, you desire honest love based on itself and not based mainly on an idea of good conduct. Love is the more you want to be. It is love you are coming to. The freedom of love within your life is growing. The same way as a flower grows to the sun and the leaves grows in chlorophyll, so do you grow to the sun of love. You grow and glow in the love within you that I, the Father of love, shine on you. And, so, you grow closer to me. The closer you grow to me in your heart for no reason but to be closer to me who is love full-blown, the closer you grow to yourself. Life in the world heralds you to your own being, and, here on earth, you catch up to your very self.